I'm Blackbright, broadcasting out of the UK. Welcome to my channel. I just wanted to know about, you know, I wanted to talk about differences and the fact that we are actually the same. And, you know, a lot of times we do hone on about our differences, and I know that I'm guilty of that too. You know, I'm always talking about the black and white because those are differences. But what we need to concentrate on is our similarities. So I decided to write down a few notes to kind of get us thinking into how similar we actually are. Okay, so this I put down here, it's so strange that despite our different personalities, backgrounds, races and preferences, we all want the same thing. What are those things? We want a healthy family life. We are healthy and we want them to be healthy. We want a comfortable home. Now, a comfortable home is different to different people. A comfortable home for the homeless means somewhere dry and warm. A comfortable home over the regular John Joe is a warm home with electric, gas and water. Middle class version of a comfortable home would be a mortgage, a place big enough to accommodate a family. A rich person's version of a comfortable home would be a place that has surplus, enough place to entertain their friends and their families when they came, large gardens and, you know, plenty of rooms and TVs and all that kind of stuff. So that would be their version of a comfortable home. But the fact of the matter is, even though our needs might be different, we all want the same thing. Food, clean water, clean air. The poor don't really have much of a choice. They make do. Middle class. So I've got a got an appointment in a minute. Yeah, I've got an appointment in 10 minutes. So I do sound, I hope I don't sound as if I'm rushing, but I am rushing. Food, clean water and clean air. Poor doesn't really have much choice. The middle class have a choice depending on their budget. And the rich, their cupboards are probably stacked to the brim. But we all require food and, you know, beverages of some sort. Source of income. The poor, any amount that will meet their basic needs. We all need an income, regardless of the source. Middle class, it might be job and self-employment. The rich, it would be good investments. It would be profit, probably. But we all want a stable economy so that we're not in a situation, a financial situation, that is worse off than we are now. We all want a sense of belonging. Caring, companionship, sharing with others, acknowledgement and acceptance. We all want to be acknowledged. We all want to be accepted, regardless of colour, race, creed, age, gender. We all want to be accepted. Peace of mind. We all want moments of joy. We want support in our moments of sadness. We want safe arrival to and from our destinations. We want days free of injustice and discrimination against protected characteristics, protected characteristics of gender, race, ethnicity, religion, disability and age. We don't want to be discriminated against that. And there will be a lot where you actually fall in regardless. If you're white, whether you're black, whether you're Asian, it doesn't really matter. You don't want to be discriminated because of your age. If you're disabled, you don't want to be discriminated because of that. You know, if you're same sex, in the same sex relationship, you don't want to be discriminated against that. The same way, we don't want to be discriminated because of our race or our ethnicity. So it applies to all of us. None of us want to be discriminated against. And we all want a peaceful transition at the end. Sometimes we confuse the ideal world with the real world. Sometimes our idealistic expectations are unrealistic. Is it reasonable to expect, for white people to expect, an all-white country? Especially when there's only 20% people of colour. Did you know that? As of 2019, 80% of the UK is white. You might not know that because you see a few black faces dotted around the place. You think you're overrun, but there's only 20% people of colour. That's black, Asian, all of them. 80% is white. Okay, it goes up to 86% if you include white ethnicity. Maybe it's Polish, I don't know. And is it reasonable for black people to expect white people to treat them as equal when they've been indoctrinated to think otherwise? Are we asking too much? So all I'm saying is that, are they unrealistic expectations? Are we expecting too much? Are we idealizing each other, our world? If we focus on personality, preferences, interpretations, stereotypes, styles and methods and protected characteristics, division is bound to happen. Regardless of where we come from, what we look like, let's respect differences. After all, every one of us wants to be loved and accepted and feel a sense of belonging despite our differences. And that's all I wanted to say. Bye-bye.